faced with mental health was definitely the transition between being a teenager to going to an adult, education wise, because whenever you're a teenager, you only have like a minimum amount of worries and responsibilities, and school isn't like too much. But then whenever you get to your freshman year of college, it transitions so rapidly. You start having way more responsibilities, assignments due different days at different times, you have different classes. Just overall, the spectrum of responsibilities goes so much higher than whenever you're a teenager. And I think it really took a toll on me mentally because I wasn't used to having that many responsibilities. But the form that I overcame it was definitely literally trial and error. I feel like I tried different study methods and it really taught me how to like time manage. And I feel like the overall factor of just like really going through it instead of avoiding doing stuff will help you transition easily. The way I cope being a first generation college student is really asking a lot of questions to anybody, because I feel like since I want to be a registered nurse, no one in my family took that route. So, I mean, in a way you feel really lost, but then you really just have to get yourself out there and not be afraid to ask questions to other people. You know, there's been a lot of times where I don't know how to do something and I literally have to make phone call after phone call after phone call to get my answer. But it's really just like pushing and persevering through. And because, I mean, at the end of the day, if you don't have like no one helping you, or like you're too shy to ask questions, you're gonna stay in one position all your life. So you really just have to like get out of your comfort zone and everything and not be afraid to ask questions. There have been definitely a couple times where the transition has affected my academic performance, and I feel like it was overall in my freshman year, just because of the fact that I wasn't prepared to go through like the level of hard that I did. And I didn't do too good. Like, for example, on my first couple exams, like I can admit it that I did not do good because I wasn't used to like the pace. I wasn't used to like what was on it or like the level of difficulty it was gonna be. But I'm just glad I went through that, because now for future exams, I know what it takes and that you have to study so much and really, again, just time manage. You have to take some time to yourself, some time for homework, some time for studying, in order to get a good grade in a class, really. It's all important factors.
Okay, so some support systems that have been instrumental through my journey has definitely been the support of my family. All of my family, there's been three of them that have graduated from Stan. And I mean, they were all, again, first generations too. No one before them had graduated. And I feel like they always ask me how I'm doing and what I could do better, or like they'll really push me and everything. They always give me advice, and I feel like their support has helped me a lot. And also I have a lot to thank for like my friends and everything, because we're all in college and we all push each other to get like good grades and everything. Also, the gym has been really good because it really helps like take out the stress of everything, because there's just so much going on all the time that it kind of gives you free time to yourself. And yeah. Okay, so the way I balance my self-care with the demands of college life is, I mean, it took me a while to do. I feel like my sophomore year, I'm taking more time to myself, because my freshman year, I made my life revolve around school. And I would stay home from a lot of family parties and stuff and miss out on a lot of stuff because of school. But then going into my sophomore year, I legit told myself that it can't be your whole entire life. Like, you can't miss out on family stuff, on friend stuff. Like, you just have to make time apart, dedicate certain times to that one thing solely only. And yeah, I feel like the most self-care that I usually do for me is like at nighttime, whenever I have time, I enjoy doing my skincare. That is something I really enjoy doing. And I like going to visit my grandparents and everything. I feel like little stuff like that, like with my family, it really helps me push forward towards my nursing degree.
Okay, so some advice I could give to other students or individuals going through the same thing
would definitely be to trust the process that it will get better. And it really takes discipline in order to do stuff and to stick by it even though you don't want to do it, because it'll benefit you in the end. And I'd say just always take time to yourself, because mental health has a lot to do with your academic success. Like, if you're not in a good mental space, and you're like studying for an exam, like, you're gonna be unmotivating yourself, saying like, oh my god, I'm gonna do so bad, and you will end up doing bad if you have that mentality, compared to if you like have good mental health and everything, like, you're really motivating yourself and like having confidence in yourself too. I mean, you're gonna do good on an exam, you put in the work, you'll get the good grade. So I'd say just definitely take time to yourself and always take care of yourself too.
So my perspective on mental health has changed drastically just because of the fact that I feel like whenever you're a teenager, or at least like for me, I didn't pay much attention to it, but it's because I generally feel like I was happy and everything. Like, I would always, like, during lunch, like, we would always laugh with my friends and everything, and that, like, motivated me to go to school because I always had such a good time with all my friends and everything. And I feel like going into college, like, or at least for me, like, I'm really introverted now compared to whenever I was younger. And I usually just go to class and come home. Like, that's my thing, because I like being with my family better instead of being like with a lot of people and everything. But it changed in the way that, since, you know, the transition from teenager to adult, like, you're going to more lonelier times, if that makes sense. You don't have a lot of kids around you trying to make you laugh anymore. Like, it's not like that anymore. And I feel like it, like, kind of affected me a lot, because, I mean, I definitely had, like, bad mental health space, like, my first couple months of college, because I was like, wow, like, this is a little bit depressing. But, I mean, you have to make the most of it. At the end of the day, you only have yourself. So, I mean, you really have to take time to yourself to kind of explore different things that you like. And so a pivotal moment that helped with my self-acceptance would definitely be getting together with my boyfriend. And I feel like before I was really scared to say anything and not be outspoken with myself, or, you know, sugarcoat stuff. And I feel like that's something my boyfriend taught me, is that I really need to be more outspoken for myself and everything. He helps me with that a lot. And I just feel like he's definitely been the one pushing me towards my degree. Like, there'll be times where, like, I'll get not a good grade on an exam and I'll be crying. But I mean, he's always there to push me. He's like, that's always part of the process and everything. Like, it's part of it. Like, this is okay. Like, don't worry about it. But I feel like definitely his support has helped me through a lot, like, through my self-acceptance and everything.